this is interesting. Money. Oh, you can buy these. Yeah, it's for sale. I like how he took this off of her crown. This one's fun. Oh, the Grim Reaper. Oh, they have a flashlight there. I guess if you wanted to.
Oh, I think it's the...
To like prove it's real money.
Oh, is that what it is? I thought maybe they printed.
Or is there
the
what is
root of all evil?
Oh, so never mind. Never mind. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Not on the real. Yeah. What does that one say? Probably the same thing. Oh no, death.
Death. What?
Death and taxes.
Death and taxes. Yeah. Cool.
I didn't even think to look at the outside.
Oh yeah, let's go over there.
Most people understandably get a different impression of it than what I got when I bought it.
Okay. I'm gonna do a little twirl here. I'm gonna get this one. Although your hair and your outfit really go well with it, I have to say. Like the yellow and the blue. Bulbs too.
Is that painted on or are those just like warm exposure?
Archival pigment print. I don't know what that means.
Is this painted on or are the...
Yeah,
look at that. That's pretty amazing.
Turn it around. Yeah.
All of these works are from New York in the 1950s.
Got it. Yeah, this...
New York,
yeah,
1958. Yeah. Those are 59. Those are early 60s.
This almost feels Chagall-ish.
It does. He knew Chagall. They were in Paris studying at the same time.
Oh, wow. Okay. Yep. Okay. looks like spaghetti.
Yeah.
It made me think of Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs.
Yeah, that makes sense.
There was something over here I wanted to see. This one.
Thanks. Thank you so much, man.
Upper West, 2021. The street feels too narrow, but like, oh, that's pretty. There's nothing in there. Text messages. I actually kind of like the idea of this for something. This is gross. Is that underwear?
That is underwear.
Calm. Keep calm. Little Eiffel Towers. You don't know me. Is that a bar of soap?
Yeah, I think so. Open the door.
Well, I guess I won't know you.
Those are fun.
Yeah.
She's, it's all her.
Oh, she.
She's a photographer. She is the mom. She does.
Oh.
By herself. She
wow.
Oh, so she just sets it up herself.
And yep. And she did. She went to, her brother owns a van in a warehouse.
Okay.
In Youngstown, Ohio. That's where she's from.
Oh.
And she set herself up there for 3 weeks and just did this, series of photographs.
Wow.
And they're pretty
okay.
Cool. And her, she originally started out making these kind of cynical photographs of her kids and her.
Okay.
But eventually, what happened, kids grew up and they're like, now we don't. So she started, just using herself. And,
good.
And they became much more psychologically driven.
Yeah.
Introspective. It just works.
Yeah.
I love, things like this peel and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
All that.
I just, the process is so interesting. This is pretty. This one is, okay, about crochet.
Okay.
I can see that influence on here. Where are they going? Only $35.
Yeah.
Oh, for that paper one.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But and already have a certificate.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Why not?
Maybe I'll come back. This is cool. Yeah. What you make art too? You? That's yours over
yes.
there. Oh, this is your stuff.
Yeah.
And you paint this one?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. Where are you from?
South Korea.
South Korea also?
Yeah.
안녕하세요.
안녕하세요. Everybody knows.
Yeah, okay.
Everybody wants to say.
Yeah, yeah.
안녕하세요.
Who makes these?
It's Hwang Ji-young. Yeah.
And where is this artist from?
It's Korea.
Another Korean artist.
Yeah.
Okay. So all the artists are
yes,
Korean
yes.
here. Okay. These are fun. Is it made from paper? Mixed media.
It almost looks like foam board.
Oh, yeah.
I know what reminds me of my friend who was in architecture school. Like do you know if it's planning to come to New York?
Like no, to know that that's gonna work, you know what
yeah.
I mean? Like it almost feels like feathers or
yeah.
something. Feels almost Japanese, and it's like the wave design, tsunami. Yeah. Oh, okay.
So I thought...
same artist. Yeah. I bet these look different in different light.
Oh yeah.
So like, it must change, which makes it more dynamic.
Yeah.
Naked lady behind a trunk. She's got like a big thing on her ankle. I know, I'm like looking at this and I'm like, what's with her ankle? Her feet look really big. That does not seem smart. Unless she was, they weren't really together.
I think they probably weren't really together.
That seems like the stupidest thing. Okay. Okay. I really like these.
I do too.
Yeah.
This is like the actual effect.
Oh, like it's okay.
Metal that they must spray paint to give it that definition.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, okay. So
yeah. And then they photograph it with certain light. The textures on it, it's so... I don't particularly like the silver. Ink ones. I think they're ink. Yeah, ink on paper.
Yeah, I agree.
wood block print.
What's that?
Wood block print. Bamboo path. No wonder it's so peaceful. Just glass. When I said school of fish before, it's like really playing with that here. That's so cool.
I feel like at some point I'm going to try and make
them. Yeah, you
have. It'll be nearly as good.
But it would, I mean, these are so good that even if yours was half as good, it would still be awesome, you know? Yeah. I feel like you could get like old spoons or something, you know, like old cutlery.
I feel like you could buy metal discs like this.
Oh, you must be able
just
to.
Just like hammer them together.
Yeah.
Or like these leaves. I bet you could almost buy something like that pre-made.
Yeah.
And then.
Yeah.
Just get like a watercolor or like a light paint that'll.
Oh, yeah. That's how, like, these have no color on them.
Yeah.
And these have just been, like, given a hue. There's so much to see. Oh, wow. Oh, that's so tempered glass.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so cool.
It reminds me, my grandma has this. It's like a painting of a sunset with a light behind it, but it's like super old, so it's like very.
Like these, you know, mega cities, like where you just.
And it was a lady who, she basically took paper strips and did them together, like similar. But then she would like put them round things, like bodies and stuff. I bought a book of it. I have it.
Okay.
I don't remember at all what her name was.
Okay. When I was in Singapore, I did this Airbnb experience where this girl, she studied at Parsons here in New York, and she made like her own new fabric. Like apparently there's some sort of catalog of fabric.
Okay.
Like it, so if you invent a new kind of fabric, you can get it registered in this like internationally recognized catalog, you know?
Okay.
So if she made the fabric out of old like cassette tape, like tape.
Okay.
And she just would weave the tape.
Yeah, yeah.
And then she, it became a new fabric. And designers were making like clothing out of it and stuff. So I did an experience where I would have to weave my own fabric together, and then like they took like a what's it called? Like the side of your head? The profile. Yeah, profile photo of your head. And then they would put the fabric you wove behind it. And and then you could leave with that. But I don't have it anymore. The shoes are cute.
Yeah, I like
them. I have, you know, the authentic foot binding shoe from China. So it's like on decoration in my bedroom. It's like on the shelf, you know. And I'm like, this is so cool.
space on my wall or $15,000 to purchase this, but if I did,
you would want this one? What? Why do you love it? Like, what?
Just something about it.
You need to buy a house so you have somewhere to put it. Oil and crayon. It almost feels like a moonscape.
Yeah.
Like the moonscape and Earth came together. And said, yeah, we can make that happen. I don't know. What, do you like that one more than this one?
So, I think so. Just because I think the boat stands out.
Oh, I agree with that. I agree with that.
I think it's just the amount of sky.
Yeah.
Like, just like the insignificance of the person.
Yeah.
Really
okay. Okay. I do think these are very pretty. And I do, I like this idea of maybe she painted the whole flower and then ripped it up.
Yeah.
I really like that idea. Oh my god, that's very pretty. Because then you don't have to get your flower perfect when you paint it.
Yeah.
Can just these are burn holes on paper. Yeah, this, the texture in the whole, this whole space is really fun.
This one of the farms is my favorite.
This one?
Yeah.
I just love the movement. Like, they're still, but they feel like they're moving, you know? These look really interesting on camera. It looks different on camera than it does.
Oh, yeah.
See?
Oh, yeah.
And then, like, the way the camera captures it is very different from the way it looks.
I wonder if it's just because the image is smaller, and so
it's compressing it somehow.
Yeah. So it looks,
people really want to connect with the artist. They want to, a lot of, there's a certain type of buyer who wants to know the story of the artist and feel like
they're supporting that person. So they'll only buy if they get to interact with the artist. And then they'll want to follow that person's life. You know what I mean? Like, where else are they showing in the future? What are new projects? So it's like the app has to give you a lot of backstory and a way to interact directly with the artist. To, you know, allow for a more personal connection. But I don't know if Instagram would just solve for that. You know what I mean? And if it's not even necessary. Oh, this is really neat.
Yeah.
What they did with these, with the cardboard here.
Those ones there.
Which ones?
All of them.
All the, yeah. It's a tear that tells a story. Yeah.
I think this one's my favorite though, without the tear. This one with just the like.
Oh, the mess above her head?
Yeah.
Like she's all confused or something?
Yeah, no, totally. It's like something you would see in like an anime or something.
Yeah. Like, oh, these are pretty. I don't think the camera is going to capture this one, but that's really cool.
Yeah.
Pumpkin heads. That's neat. That's pretty cool. It's so nifty, because I have a bigger camera, and once I got this, I was like, I'm not taking that big thing around anywhere. Yeah, like I use it at home, or if I want to do photography.
And you can kind of move it around. And
it's a much
stable,
smoother image, yeah.
You don't need a gimbal.
Right, it's built in, right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How's the resolution?
You can do 4K. Okay. Yeah, so I usually do 1080 because I want... to get more footage, but it can do 4K.
That's
amazing. Just like holding this.
Looking at things through the camera.
That happens sometimes. I'm like, la 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 la. I'm like, oh, I pushed the wrong button. We're not recording. It's a DJI. It's called a Pocket 2. Mm-hmm. But I think in November they're coming out with the next one, Pocket 3. But it's
pretty
really
HD.
Yeah, it can do up to 4K. And it's on a gimbal, so its image is very stable. Yeah.
Sorry.
It's okay. No, no problem. Maybe I was at the time. But what I did was, I didn't have, like, a vision for what it should be.
Uh-huh.
I just kept throwing used tea bags on canvas until I looked at it and thought it was done.
Yeah.
And it looked like a guy with a mohawk.
Okay.
When I was done.
I like that.
And then my mom, when I moved, she put it in the attic, and all the fucking moisture messed it up. So it doesn't look bad, it just doesn't look like what it used to look like.
Yeah.
I was like, why would you put my art in the attic? That is the worst.
Just put it on the refrigerator.
Right. It's like, this is the worst idea ever. And then she would, like, pick out the ugliest thing and hang it up in the living room. And I was like, why that one? That one's so ugly. Like, oh, I like that one. I'm like, but it's so ugly. And I'm like, this is drawing me in. This, whatever this is. But it's the same thing when I make videos. It's like, you think you got something really great up there and nobody watches it. And then the dumbest thing, it's like, gets like 20,000 views, like, you know, I don't know, or whatever. Feels like fabric.
Yeah.
Oh.
I wasn't saying I'm giving you that.
I see another Queen Elizabeth.
I guess that's technically mine also.
Oh god, yeah. That is creepy, yeah.
My kind of art.
These are kind of fun down here, too.
Yeah, so I was looking at, I loved the, I could ask her if you could
connected somewhere. Are pretty. New York and Tokyo.
That's also my kind of creepy.
It's also what?
My kind of creepy art.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's made from natural pigments.
Okay.
Light colors.
Yeah.
So maybe on the highlights there.
Yeah.
So for example, like the sushi shells.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It's like an Asian, super old Japanese sticky.
Okay.
Okay.
Before they imported the royal.
Okay. Color. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Kind of going back in time, but
yeah,
same view.
Okay.
That was very pretty.
I just started taking an actual dyeing class.
Like, it's simple in the concept, but, like, the execution must be...
So these, okay. I thought these were just pictures of actual, just, like, grapes or whatever that...
was making paintings out of nail polish.
Okay.
And this looks like what I was coming out. I mean, this is way more, like, bigger, and it's... They dumped a lot on there, you know, whatever it is. But it reminds me... What? Oh, okay. But it reminds me of my nail polish paintings. I really like these too.
Yeah.
They're so delicate. Oh, this is how she works. Her name means fight.
Okay.
I don't know. It's almost like sequins on it.
That is very cool.
Bunch of $1. It's $25,000. It's the most expensive piece that we've seen.
No, there were some that were more expensive.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't see that.
There was one place where everything was. The one where it had that purple.
Oh, yeah.
Resin thing.
Yeah.
Everything in that place was like $50,000.
Oh, really? I didn't notice that.
I think that resin thing was the cheapest thing there, and it was like $22 or something.
Oh, okay. Back over here. These before, but you can flip it. Whoops! See how she did it. So she puts a backing on it to support the. Yeah, got it. Otherwise, it might just rip or not hold, I guess. Okay. Very cool. And snakes on the Capitol. Dun dun dun. It's almost like French fries sticking out. Hanji paper.
It almost looks like.
Yeah, it does look
it
like stone.
The glaze that's on it or something.
Yeah, you're right. Cause
like it looks like they took rolls, cut them in half, and then glazed them so that they would stay together and be hard. Or like dipped them in a glue or something.
Right. Hanji. Wow. Okay, this one's not covered. You could mess it up. I like the frame on this too.
Yeah.
Like, there's writing all along the frame. But I don't know what it says. Wood sticks. This is impressive. I don't think I can get the whole thing in one shot, but... Oh well. Wang Hei-jong. Ink wash on Korean paper. Oh, this looks like shit. Like this. Hand-dyed hanji paper.
Like sticks of juicy fruit gum.
You're right, yeah.